who's ready to get their praise on? Come on, let's give them a shout of praise this morning. God is good, amen. All the time, God is good. Come on, let's close our eyes. Father, we thank you for this day. We give everything to you, Lord. We praise you, we worship you, you get all the honor, you get all the glory, Father God. We thank you for bringing us here safely. We pray for those that are on their way, Lord, that you protect them as well. And just use us this morning, Lord. And we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Who knows our God reigns? Amen. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. because we serve a glorious God. Amen. Come on. Keep on praising His name this morning.
Jesus, you shine for all the see you are glorious. You are glorious.
Come on, sing it out. God is good, amen. Come on, who believes that with me this morning? Amen. We'll be right back.
ocean and sea, my faith will stand. So I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When the oceans rise, my soul rests in your embrace. Thank you.
want you to reflect on this song. As the song says, take me deeper. Take us places we've never been before. Have to be careful, because oceans and waves and circumstances and financial issues and marriage problems and child's problems are going to come against you. That's the thing, you want to go deeper, but you got to be careful when you go deeper, because when you go deeper, new things arise. But we have to truly understand and comprehend that when we go deeper, don't look at the negative side, look at who's walking right beside you. Look who's walking, who's your lifesaver. That's what we have to look at. And as we sing this part again, I want you to really understand who's walking with you today. Understand who's your lifesaver. Reflect on who pulled you out of that drowning waters when you were up under sea level. So as we sing that again, I just want you to worship the Father this morning. And thank Him for all He's done. To be able to be that mobile church and to be that, not necessarily going across the state, but just simply coming outside our four walls and bringing the gospel to not just you, but to this apartment complex, the people shopping at Family Dollar, anyone who's passing by, and everyone's going to get a daily dose of their encouragement. So it's a great blessing that you are here with us.
If you are standing up, you may be seated in your car, if you're outside, or whatever the case may be. I just got a few announcements, and then we'll move on with the service, because that's why we're here. So, I just want to welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us and taking some time out of your weekend to join us. It means a lot to us. Do we have any first-time visitors here at LCM? Maybe you could, not raise your hand, but honk your horn. Any first-time visitors? Oh, right in the front row. Praise God. Right in the back, right there. Praise God. Welcome to Last Chance Ministries. Thank you for joining us. She's proud to be here. There we go. Praise God. Well, thank you for joining us. We can't really do what we usually do and give you a token and all that of appreciation, but we could just simply say thank you for joining us and hope to see you in the future. And we'll be all back to normal hopefully soon. But as you know, this month of April is the month of Child Abuse Awareness Month. And this is a very important month for a lot of us and a lot of people, because we believe at Last Chance Ministries that the youth, the children, the young adults are the next generation at Last Chance Ministries. And that's what we have to cherish here. And that's what we have to understand, that just because they're youth, someday we have some youth rising up that are going to be our pastors, our leaders, our presidents, our lawyers, doctors, police officers. And that's what we have to understand, and not just look at children as children, but look at them as the next rising leaders of the city of San Antonio. And I want you to really reflect on this month, because it's a very important month, and as much as it's a sad month, and it goes on, and it's not just this month that we should be worried about, but this month was designated for this. 5 children die in the U.S. in one day from child abuse. 5. And we're not talking about it, and it's not making breaking news. But that's what should be making breaking news. 5 children in the U.S. die in one day. Multiply that 365 days a year. That is a lot of children. Over 5,000 cases in Bexar County. 10 children are abused and only one gets reported. So what's going on with the other 9? And especially in this time, there's no school. It's in lockdown. So we don't know what's going on. We don't know what's happening behind closed doors. Only God knows. But what we have to do, we have to be that army that's going to stand in that front line, to be those people who are gonna make it aware to other people. We gotta be those people that say, you know what, we protect the children. And it's not just this month that you should do it, it should be every day. And as you see on these 3, there's 3 over here and 3 over here, and then these people did it just to, they're out of their heart to reflect and represent the children. And they look pretty good. Whoever did these, they did really good. I like these over here, and that's really good. This one has a wig, and I think that one's your Stacy, right? Stacy's over here with the red hair and all that, so that's great. But if you have one of those, please bring them on next time, and we can put them up here. We want to really, and we want to make it aware, and we want to make people aware that there are people that care out there, and there are people that are really, really focused on this. So that's one thing that I wanted to announce today, guys. So throughout this day, just reflect on that, and just keep those children in prayer. Anyone who's affected by it, anyone who has died from it, we just keep those children in prayer. But I have a message for the youth. As you know, I'm one of the youth leaders in the back where the youth have their services. And I have to say, I miss the youth like crazy. I miss teaching them. I miss talking to them and hearing them out. I miss just feeding them snacks and games and all that great stuff. But if you're any of the youth are out there, if you have a youth in your vehicle, I want you to know that we love you. The youth ministry, Last Chance Ministries, we love you. We miss you. I know the youth, as we know, are the next generation. So we want you to stay in touch. We don't want you to get distracted and get derailed on this time of COVID-19. So if you are a youth, I want you to tune in every Thursday at 7 p.m. I'm getting more feedback from the adults than the youth, but it's all right. We're still doing a Bible study. But if you are a youth, I want you to tune in every Thursday at 7 p.m. We're going to have a youth Bible study. We play some games, and we just have fun and talk at your level. And that's what we're here for. We just want you to know that we still care. We're still here. We haven't gone nowhere. But speaking of Bible study, yes, praise God. Speaking of Bible study, Spanish Bible study every Tuesday and Thursday at 7 p.m. So if you like the Spanish Bible study, or if you attend the Spanish service, please, they strongly encourage you, Pastor Quijada and his wife, they strongly encourage you to join them on Facebook Live every at 7 p.m. every Tuesday and Thursday. But that's all I got for today, guys. But if you could just raise your Bibles or raise your iPad, your phone, and we're going to say our Bible pledge. We really want to incorporate this, even though we're outside. And a big thanks to everyone who's just parked around the parking lot in the back. We see you and we're here. Thank you for joining us. But here we go, on the count of three, we're going to say this loud and clear, truly meaning with all our heart. One, two, three. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I'll make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. If you agree with me, let's give him a great praise. Keep that going and help me welcome your senior pastor, my father, Pastor Junior Robles.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's give it up for Jesus here today. Gracias, Señor. What a blessing to be in the house of the Lord.
Welcome once again to Last Chance Ministries. What a blessing. A beautiful day it is, man, today. God has made some amazing days, and what a blessing to wake up this morning. So, has God been good to you? Yes or no?
Come on, has God been good to you? If he woke you up this morning, you should praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Gracias, Señor.
God is an amazing God. God is so awesome. I'm so excited just to call him my daddy. He's my father. Amen. He's the one that woke me up this morning. I'm excited for that. So listen, all of you way in the back, thank you for your faithfulness. I see you guys out there. Amen. Are y'all barbecuing or what? Yes. All right. I'll be there afterwards. Hallelujah. Send me un taquito. Amen. All of us, all you cars, about 100 cars here, everybody go to the back to have barbecue for you. Hey, listen, last night we had an amazing time. We had a drive-in last night, and we watched the movie Overcomer, and it was a blessing. Are there any overcomers in this place here today? Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Every single person in this place right here are overcomers. Because look at the year, 2020, man. The roaring 20s, where the lion comes out and he roars in the name of Jesus, and you are still alive, and this is the time that we come together and praise the name of Jesus, amen? So today is gonna be a good day. Sunday resurrection that passed, it was pretty cool because during that service, my son was able to introduce to you this Messiah, this Jesus that lives, and we mentioned him different, like undescribable and invisible, that you can't live without him, and the grave couldn't hold him, and so forth and so forth. But this morning I wanna continue to talk about and let you know about our Father. I wanna let you know about Jesus. I wanna let you know that the power that's within your reach. Can everybody just extend your hands? Just extend your hands just a little bit to the front. That's how close the power that is for you, that's how close your blessing is within your reach. And today my message is entitled, The Power That Is Before Us. Amen. The power that is before us. And before I go any further, those of you that want to go to the bathroom or whatever, the porta potties, do not use them. There's a bathroom inside this building. And you can go to the bathroom. Not everybody at the same time, of course, but thank you for practicing social distancing. Thank you for being obedient with your mask and so forth. You may come out of your car if you want once in a while, just as long as you have your mask, and don't be going around giving people hugs. Just give them an air hug, all right? So I'm gonna give you an air hug right now. Hallelujah, I just hugged everybody. Praise God. Amen. The power that is within our reach. My prayer is that before this service is over, that you will have a different outlook of life. So I want you to please join me in the book of Matthew, please. Matthew chapter 15. I'm going to read out of Matthew chapter 15. I want you to follow with me. It's in the New Testament. If you have something a little different, maybe like a different version of the Bible, just follow along with me. The book of Matthew chapter 15, starting in verse 30 is where I'll begin. Matthew chapter 15, verse 30. I'll give you a second to get there. El libro de Mateo, capítulo 15, versículo 30. Se me pegó los español de Pastor Carlos. Hallelujah. Matthew 15, verse 30. Here we go. The Bible reads, great crowds came to him, bringing the lame. Remember these names. Bringing the lame, bringing the blind, bringing the crippled, the mute, and many others, and laid them at the feet of Jesus, and he healed them. And the people were amazed when they saw the mute speaking, the crippled made well, and the lame walking, and the blind seeing. The crowds wondered when they saw the mute speak, the maimed made whole, the lame walk, and the blind see, and they glorified the God of Israel. So Father, I ask you that you anoint my lips. Let it be you speaking through me, Lord. I pray for every person that's way in the back, to the left, to the right, in this place, those that are watching in the line, that you may open up their ears, Father God, that we can tell the neighbors, hold on, neighbor, we can talk later. Right now, I'm going to listen to the voice of God. No distractions here today. Let us give you this time right now in reverence to hear your voice. Speak to us, Father. Let us hear what you have to say to us. Because if you woke us up and you brought us here today, you must have something for us. The power that is before me, I want to experience it. So Lord, fall fresh upon this place. Everyone in the apartment complex, those in their houses, those in the stores, that they may hear a word from you today like never before. And Satan, you have no room, no authority, no power over this place. So we rebuke you, we command you to flee right now in the name of Jesus. And I ask you that you anoint my lips, Father, and let it be you speaking through me. In Jesus' name I pray. And everyone say, amen and amen. Hallelujah. I want you to open up your ears, and I want you to hear what the Lord has to say. And I want to start off, I'm going to give you just real quick, and then I'm going to talk about every single one of them that I'm going to tell you. But it's going to be really quick, so you got to write down the scriptures, and then I'm going to come back to it. So let's start off with the blind. The blind. Anybody know someone that is blind? I have a brother. He was born 1 pound, and he wasn't born blind, but back in the day, 30 years ago, there wasn't any of this things that they have now. So under oxygen for so many months, it affected his retina and his cornea, and he went from seeing just a little bit to now he's legally blind. But he's an amazing, he plays all these instruments, every instrument you can think of. He's an amazing man of God, and he loves music. He has a great ear. So when I speak about the blind, I'm speaking about something that is real near to me as well. And if the power is before us, then I pray for my own brother that one day he can see himself. And here, the blind, in the book of Matthew chapter 20, verse 30, make sure you take notes. The book of Matthew chapter 20, verse 30, it talks about these two blind men. If you go to another scripture, it might talk about Bartimaeus, the blind man. And here they are sitting in the roadside. And I want you to picture yourself here. You're sitting in your car. You're sitting where you're at. Because everything that is in the Bible is for us. We might not be blind, but when I get to the story and when I'm done, you can understand what I'm talking about. And these two men are sitting down by the roadside. And they heard that Jesus was coming, that he was passing by. They can't see him, but they heard. Just like a lot of people, you know that there's going to be service on Sundays and Wednesdays, and you heard that something was going to be happening. And God allows us to sit here and listen. And here are these two blind men. They heard that Jesus was passing by, and they began to shout. They began to shout, say, Lord, Son of David, have mercy on us. And they were rebuked. The disciples and other people told them to be quiet, but they shouted even louder. And verse 31 says that Jesus stopped and he called them. What do you want me to do for you? We want to see. We want our sight. Jesus had compassion, the word of God says. And he touched their eyes, and immediately they received their sight and followed him. I want you to ask your neighbor, what do you want Jesus to do for you? Come on, ask him. Way in the back, tell somebody, what do you want Jesus to do for you? Ask him. And if you don't have anybody next to you, what do you want Jesus to do for you this morning? Let's talk about the lame man. The lame man, unable to walk, unable to stand. from the very beginning, from birth, never experienced standing on his own two feet. The book of John chapter 5 talks about this man that is laying by the pool of Bethesda. A lot of you know this story. Laying there for 38 years. Can you imagine? His job was just to go into the pool as soon as the waters were stirred up. Jesus saw him there and he goes up to him and he asked him the question, would you like to get well? Would you like to get well? As you're sitting there, allow God to ask you the same question. Do you want to get well? I can't, sir. I can't do it. Every time I want to go into the pool, someone beats me to it and gets there before me. Someone always goes ahead of me. Jesus says, stand up, pick up your mat, and walk. Let's talk about the deaf and the mute. Mark chapter 7, verse 31 through 37 tells us that people brought a man to Jesus. He was deaf and he could hardly even speak. He couldn't even talk. And they begged Jesus to please heal this man. Jesus takes him aside, touches the man's tongue, puts his finger in his ear, and the Bible says that the man began to hear and his tongue was loose in the name of Jesus. Matthew 12, verse 9 through 12 talks about a man with a withered hand. Jesus tells this man, stretch out your hand. And when he did, he was completely restored. Listen to these stories. The crippled man that you will hear, some of you know the story in the book of Mark chapter 2, verse 1 through 5. Jesus enters into Capernaum. Immediately, many gathered around the house. They heard that Jesus was in the house, just the way you are gathered here. There were so many people ready to hear, wanted to ask questions, wanted to know why, wanted to get healed. They went because they wanted something from God. There was a man that was sick, that was paralyzed. Four men came and picked him up, and you know the story. They couldn't get through the door, so they did something crazy. They went up through the roof, and they brought the man, made a hole in the roof, and brought the man down through the roof. Jesus, because of his faith, Jesus sees him and says, because of your faith, son, your sins are forgiven. Mark chapter 4, verse 35, verse 4 to 1. You will find the story of the disciples that were told to go to the other side. And the storm arose. Wind started to get real strong. Rain started to come really bad. A furious storm, it says. Disciples were scared. They go and wake up Jesus. Jesus gets up, rebukes the wind, and he says to the waves, quiet, be still. The book of Matthew chapter 14, verse 13 to 21, Jesus tells us about a time where the disciples were directed to sit the people down because they were hungry, but there wasn't enough food. But Jesus tells them, sit the people down, just the way everybody's sitting down right here. He gets five loaves of bread, two pieces of fish, looking up to the heavens, and he gave thanks for something that didn't really seem like it was too much. He broke the bread, and over 5,000 people were fed, and it still says that still 12 baskets were left over, full, and everybody was satisfied. I pray today that this word will satisfy your thirst. I pray that this word here today that will touch your heart like never before. I pray that the word of God, the power that is before us here today, will just cause your bones like a fire shut up in my bones, and that you will rise up and shout the name of Jesus, the power that is before us. We started with the blind man, and I'm here to tell anyone that does not yet see. I'm here to tell anyone that might say, I just don't get it. Might be somebody here that says, you know what? I just don't see it happening. I'm talking about spiritually blind. You don't see a way out. You don't see how that marriage can be restored. You don't see how that child would ever come back. You don't see how that person would ever leave that drug. You just don't see how that alcoholic can actually be set free in the name of Jesus. You just don't see it. Because the Lord brought you here today. I believe that Jesus, He wants you to experience His power here this morning. You don't see, and you don't see it. I wrote this down. You don't see your healing because of how you are now. You see your circumstances. You look around. You look at your husband. You look at your wife. You look at your situation. You look at your finances. And you just don't see it. It seems like it's impossible. But I believe that the Lord wants me to remind you of the power that is before you here this morning. You need to shout out, hallelujah. Are you ready? You need to shout, Son of David, have mercy on me, hallelujah. Just like the blind man, Son of David, have mercy on me. And the devil will try to shut you up, just like the man were trying to shut the man up. As they heard that Jesus was coming, they shouted, Son of David, have mercy on us. And they said, be quiet. How many times you try to open up your mouth and it seems like the devil says, look, be quiet, it's not going to happen. But the Bible says that the more they told them to be quiet, the more they shouted, the louder they got. I want someone here today that if you really want it, if you really want to see it, that you shout the name of Jesus, because there's power in the name of Jesus, and say, Son of David, have mercy on me. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. I want you to know that the devil's a liar. When he wants to shut you up, you need to get louder. Anybody here who used to be loud in the world? Used to go to the market square and, oh, you know what I'm talking about? Nobody knows anything about that? Un grito para Cristo. Now, come on, somebody, un grito para Cristo. Let the devil hear you shout his holy name. Let the devil hear you. Here I am, Jesus. I praise your holy name. Gracias, Señor. Because the thing is, you can't keep your mouth shut. My son just told you right now that only one child abuse goes reported. The other nine are scared. Maybe there's an abusive person in the house. If you call the cops, fear comes upon them. And they seem like they just don't see a way out. So nine children that are being abused are not being reported. Not good. This is when we come and we put this blue ribbon, so we wear blue and we recognize and we be that voice for those that do not have a voice. You never know, it might be somebody in the apartments, might be somebody in the house around here. There was a man from New York that I heard his story, and he said that he kept on marching and marching and marching and doing marches just the way we do marches, and it just didn't make no sense to anybody. Why do you keep on marching? But he said that ladies that were trapped, I don't know if it was like 10, 15 years, that were trapped in a house being abused, that they would hear the music and they would hear the worship, but they couldn't get out because they were trapped. Praise God for those voices. And I pray that if there's anyone being abused or anyone that's in the closet or maybe someone that doesn't have a voice, cannot open their mouth, I'm here to tell you God brought us outside because everything will be exposed in the name of Jesus. The devil will release those that need to be released in the name of Jesus. And we will see people set free in the name of Jesus. We're not not here outside for nothing. God didn't bring us outside for nothing. Sometimes it doesn't make sense. We're wearing masks. We're sitting all around. You look everywhere, everybody's wearing masks, and we don't know what's going on. We just want to be obedient. The city leaders are saying this. The president is saying this. But I know that Jesus himself, the Lord Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth, he is the one that has the world in the palm of his hands. So he is the one that is in charge. He is the one that is doing what he's doing. We just got to just keep our eyes on Jesus and know that he has a plan for us. And it's not to harm us. It's to prosper us in the name that is above all names. Hallelujah. Maybe some of you have become tired. If there's anyone here that has become tired, I told you on Wednesday, the Bible says, let us not grow weary. Let us not grow weary. Because this stuff can tire you, man. This stuff can just make you want to quit. And maybe there's somebody that is tired. Just the fire is gone. You don't have the joy that you used to have. This thing can really drain you. I'm serious. Because you start hearing all these voices. As a man and a woman of God, I always tell the leaders, stay focused. Keep your eyes on the glass. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Because you can hear this voice and this voice. Hey, hey, first of all, it's not even your name. You're a son of God. You're a daughter of the Most High. You're a victorious woman. You're a Lord's chosen man. You are more than a conqueror. You are a masterpiece of God. And you need to understand that all these voices that will come against you, you start listening to these voices and you start believing something that sounds positive but is really not positive. Something that sounds good but is not really good. God says, be wise as a serpent and gentle as a dove. Listen to my voice. When I say go, go. When I say stop, stop. But a lot of times, we're listening to too many other voices that we get tired. It's like if you get a rag and you just squeeze it and it just drains everything out of you to the point where you're here, but you're really not here. Man, as I'm worshiping up at the stage and I see the lady over there in the red by the gate, I see her with her hands lifted up. And as I'm worshiping and I see the people way in the back with their hands lifted up, and I look to my left and I look to the right and I see all of you here just lifting up your hands, I get emotional because I said, look at what you're doing, Father God. You got some true worshipers in the house, Father God. You deserve to be praised. You deserve to be glorified. You deserve for those that are watching online and those that are here to lift up your holy name, because you're the King. You are awesome, Father. Hallelujah. Those are the things that bring me joy. And it should bring you joy as well, that when you look around, you see people and say, wow, how people can come together. It can be hot in the car. It can be uncomfortable. But Jesus, you deserve it all, because you were uncomfortable for us, Father God. You got spit on. You got kicked. Father God, you were left undesirable and undescribable hanging on the cross, and yet we complain for little things. Forgive us, Father God, for this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, praise the name of Jesus here this morning. Gracias, Señor. Hallelujah. Praise the name of God. We should praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That gets tired, this man that was paralyzed, that he couldn't walk, Mephibosheth, there's a guy that was dropped a long time ago when he was a child, hiding, felt like nobody. David remembers him, goes finds him, and I preached a message. Have you ever been dropped? Have you ever been trusting so much on someone that they leave you, that you never expected them to leave you? Someone dropped you so hard, you go through some things that leaves you paralyzed. You go through some things that, man, if they only knew how I smile here, but I go home crying. If they only knew how bad I was hurt and how bad I was abused and what they did to me. I'm here, but I'm really not here. I've been left paralyzed. If they only knew my pain. And I remember my wife at the Victorious Fellowship and the retreat. She came back and she told me what she shared with the ladies. And I hadn't heard that from her either. But she says, you know what? When our daughter passed away, my wife's like, I was numb. I was paralyzed. I was there, but I really wasn't there. Because it's a pain that you go through that no one understands. That you get dropped so hard that you just can't tell somebody. You can't just tell anybody because they won't understand your pain. And you stay away so you won't bring that sadness to anyone. And my wife says, man, I felt that way. I was paralyzed coming to the retreat. And this is a pastor's wife. This is someone that loves God. This is my wife. For her to have humility and humbleness to say, I was paralyzed. What happens is that you bring glory to God, because at that retreat, something happened. And I pray that something happens here today, that maybe someone of you are paralyzed, that you just can't move, that you just can't see a way out, that you just been hurt and you weren't expecting this door to shut on you. I pray this day that it'll be a day like my wife said that happened to her. She said, I don't know what happened. Something came over me. Even though I'm the pastora, I'm glad I went to the retreat, because God has given me this peace that is I can't even explain the peace that I have upon my life. I have been set free from this paralyzation. And I told my wife, praise the name of Jesus, because there is power that is before us, that if there's anyone that is paralyzed, my Jesus, hallelujah, the same God that she serves, the same God that I serve, is the same God that you serve. And I'm here to tell you that my God is here to give you a peace that no one else can give you. No wonder his name is the Prince of Peace. Because there's some people here that are just can't move, man. Stuck. Maybe it's a drug that has you that you just can't get away from it. I'm here to tell you myself. A cocaine drug dealer right here for 15 years, and I did so much cocaine. Then my God came to my rescue and he set me free. And he can set anybody that is here that might feel like you're trapped, you can't get out. There's no way. There is a way. That's why you're listening. That's why God stops you, because he has heard your prayers. He has seen your tears. Now it's up to you to do what you gotta do. You gotta understand that the power is before you. So praise the name of Jesus for us being unparalyzed. You need to surround yourself with people that care about you. This paralytic man, this man that was paralyzed, he was carried by four men up to the roof. That's how Jesus got his attention. That's how he got the attention of Jesus. If you don't have people on your side that will lift you up when you're paralyzed, that will tell you, listen, Jesus is good and take you to him, then you need to find some new friends. If you got some friends that do not encourage you, all they do is drain you, you need to get rid of those friends. Find yourself some eagles that will fly with you, that will believe with you, that will say, you know what? God is good. God is awesome. God can heal you. You need to surround yourself with men and women of God that will be on your side, not against you. Hallelujah. That will lift you up when you need someone to lift you up in the name of Jesus. We talked about the mute and we talked about the deaf. The deaf. Someone here has been wanting to shout and praise the name of Jesus, but the enemy has had your mouth shut and mute. Don't say nothing. Don't even think about it. You can't do it. Stay where you're at. If you say something, some people really want to praise God, but some have your mouth shut. And I'm here to tell you, God says, open up your mouth. Let everything that has breath praise the name of Jesus. If you have breath in you right now, praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. If you have breath, praise the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody, praise the name of Jesus. Yeah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And daughters, today your tongue, the Lord says, will be loosened in the name of Jesus. There's some people that get anxiety attacks. There's some people that hear that you get anxiety, that you get full of fear. comes upon you and you want to shout and you want to praise and you want to say something, but you just can't because that's not you. I'm here to tell you, Jesus is about to loosen that tongue, and you're going to be able to rise up against any devil that comes up against you. And you're going to be able to tell that devil, devil, get behind me, because it's not going to be you speaking. It's going to be God speaking through you. All he's looking for is a willing vessel with a mouthpiece that will say, here I am. Hallelujah. Maybe you have not heard the voice of the Lord. This is where the deaf comes in. Maybe you say, you know what, Pastor? It's been a long time. I don't even know how the voice of the Lord sounds. I haven't heard his voice in a long time. You're a little confused. Maybe you're doubting. Well, today, the power's before you. Your ears are about to hear an audible voice from the Lord. If you open up your ears, the Bible says, open up your ears. If you have ears, hear. Don't just be a hearer of the word, but be a doer of the word. I believe that there's order coming to someone's life here today. I don't know who this message is for, because every single thing that is coming out of my voice, this is the Lord speaking to you. That if you are in a place of confusion, if you're in a place of chaos, if you're in a place of darkness, if you're in a place of crying all the time, arguing all the time, disorder in your house, it's just over and over and over. This word is for you. You need to be able to hear the voice of the Lord. If God says, I am for you, not against you, take that with you. I want you to hear. If God says, I am for you, not against you, take the word from the Lord. If God says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper, I want you to hear right now that no weapon, it might form, but God wants you to hear that it will not prosper in the name of Jesus. I want you to hear that the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but I want you to hear what comes next. Jesus wants you to hear what he has to say. He says, I come to give you life in abundance in the name of Jesus. That's what I want to hear. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. We talked about the man and the disciples that were in the boat during a storm. This is a big one, man, because there's a lot of people in the storm right now. You're in a storm right now that is just hitting your boat. It's hitting your life with finances, children, relationships. It's just hit after hit after hit after hit. And you're fighting a storm. Jesus told the disciples, I want you to get on the boat and we're going to go to the other side. Listen, COVID-19, Jesus tells us, he wants us to go to the other side. We can't be in standstill. We got to get to the other side. The only way out is through. And these disciples, following Jesus, knowing Jesus, still, man, it's good, because in the Word of God is so true. Because even having a relationship with Jesus can confuse some people. And I've seen it happen so many times. On the boat, COVID-19 happens. Big old waves, big old storms. People start getting scared. Jesus is in the boat. He's asleep. The disciples, if you know the story, they go and they wake up Jesus. Jesus comes out and he speaks to the storm and he says, be quiet, be still, peace. The reason I'm telling you this, because if there's anything that you might be going through that you say, man, I just can't take this anymore, call on Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. If you're listening right now and you don't even know what in the world is going on, I guarantee you, if you just say the name of Jesus, something will happen to you right there in your car, right there where you're standing, right there where you're at. Come on, somebody say the name of Jesus, because the demons tremble when you say Jesus. The demons tremble when you say Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. And say that the name above all names, the name above cancer, the name above diabetes, the
shout the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Praise you, Father God. Worship him. Worship. Worship him right now. Come on, somebody open up your mouth and just say Jesus. Give the devil a black eye right there where you're at. Say Jesus. Addictions are being falling out. There's addictions that are falling right now. Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody pray in the name of Jesus and shout, he is awesome.
you to picture that. Go on, hallelujah. Whatever mountain you're facing, I want you to see this. I want you to see it move. Cancer, move. Diabetes, move. Addictions, move in the name of Jesus.
Keep me in the fire.
Hurt and pain, move in the name of Jesus. Alcohol, move in the name of Jesus. Every time you open up your mouth and glorify His holy name, you get His attention, just like all the stories that you heard. And when you say He's awesome, I believe I need to say this. This is something that I know that I say this all the time. I feel like there's some people here saying He's awesome, but I feel like the devil's scratching his head, looking at you, hearing your voice saying He is awesome, scratching his head saying, how can you say He's awesome if you're going through what you're going through? How can you say He's awesome if that door shut? How can you say He's awesome if you lost a child? How could you? And the devil scratching his head. And I want you to tell the devil, the reason I say my God is awesome, hallelujah, because my God, my God is a faithful God. And as long as I praise my God, He is awesome. And as long as I praise His God, my daughter, my son will be healed. As long as I praise my God, things will turn around for the good. As long as I praise and lift up His holy name, God will come through when it doesn't make no sense. If you keep on saying, my God is awesome, hallelujah. Praise Him where you're at. Praise Him where you're at. I see you going car to car, Father God. I see you in the back, Lord. I see you on the left and the right, Father. I see you in the partners. I see you by the family dollar, Father God. I see you moving in the hearts of people, Lord. Fall fresh upon them right now, Lord. Keep that worship going. Because I know that I know. There might be somebody here today. You say, Jesus, it's impossible.
My God is awesome. 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 My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keep me in the valley. Hide me from heals me when I'm broken, gives strength when I am weak, forever He reigns. My God is awesome, awesome.
Hallelujah.
Awesome.
One of my notes flew away. away, but I just got it. This is my last one. I guess the devil didn't want me to tell you this, but the last one was Genesis 17:1. I am the Almighty God.
Woo!
Hallelujah! That's it! I am the Almighty God! Wow! Hallelujah! I don't even know when that paper flew. Wow! I am the Almighty God. God always has the last word. He always has the last word. Listen, those of you that are way back in the family, daughter in the back and the side, don't leave yet. This is the most important moment of your life. If there's anyone here that says, you know what, Pastor, I don't know if I'm going to heaven or I'm going to hell. I don't know. I just know that it feels good. And I'm here to tell you, 14 years ago, 2005, I was listening, just listening. I didn't want to be there. It just so happens that I was there. And I heard a voice, I heard a message, and the name was Jesus. And I remember sitting there with a quarter ounce of cocaine in my sock in the room, and I went back to the room. I was at a retreat, and those of you that know my testimony, I went back to the room, and I flushed that cocaine down the toilet. That was 14 years ago. I felt something in my life that changed it forever. I thought just being a good father and a good husband and working, that I'm all right, but it wasn't. The devil had me blind. And maybe somebody's here right now, say, man, I'm not ready yet. You'll never be ready. Look how many good times God has saved you and taken you out and freed you and healed you. And God is a faithful God. Man, he must have a plan for you. And I remember back in 2005, I said this prayer that changed my life forever. But I'm talking about, I said this prayer with all my heart because I didn't know nothing about Jesus. I didn't ever go to church. I just said this prayer and something happened to the point where I flushed all the drugs down the toilet. And here I am 14 years later preaching the gospel. It is only by the grace of God. So if you're here today and if you're ready to say this prayer, maybe you say, you know what, I want a relationship with God. It's not about a religion. I'm not Christian, I'm not Pentecostal, I'm not a Baptist, I'm a Catholic, I'm this, I'm that. Jesus is not going to ask you that when you get to heaven. He's not going to ask you what religion you are. It's not about a religion, it's about a relationship with him. So if you're ready to give your life to Jesus, I'm going to give you an opportunity. You got to say this prayer. The Bible says you must confess it with your mouth. So I want everybody, all the believers, if you already have Jesus, just extend your hands, because there's somebody here that needs to receive Jesus into their heart. Maybe you're watching online and you know somebody that is watching. You need Jesus in your life. I'm going to give you an opportunity. Here we go, loud and clear. I want you to say this prayer and I guarantee your life will never be the same. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me for all my sins. I know that you died on the cross and you died for me, Jesus. But I also know that you rose again on the third day. And today, Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior. Jesus, I want my name written on that book of life. Jesus, I'm ready to let go of everything. And I'm ready to hold on to your hand, Lord. I need you. Today, I surrender my life to you. I want change. I want something different. I want a fresh start. And Jesus, help me, because I can't do this on my own. And I ask you all these things in Jesus' name. And everybody say, amen and amen. Come on, let's give it up for the Lord here today. Hallelujah. Gracias, Señor. If you said that prayer,
welcome to the family.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. We're about done here today. We're going to pray for the tithes and offering here that come into the storehouse. Can we get excited to give to Jesus? Amen. Praise God. We want to give God our very best, just the way he gives us his very best. I always say this, that a seed in your hand, I said it before, if you have a seed in your hand and your hand is closed, it's going to remain only a seed. But if you let go and open your hand and let the seed fall into the ground, It says that a seed that falls to the ground is planted. It produces much fruit. And I'm here to tell you, and I'm going to say it, and I'll say it again. The west side of San Antonio, the 78207, I'm tired and I'm tired and tired of it being known as one of the most poverty zip codes, as one of the most poorest, dropout rates, all this stuff, that's what it's known for. But listen, I've been here 9 years, and I've told the city of San Antonio, and I've told the mayor, and I've written letters, that this zip code of 78207, since the house of worship's been here as well, since the place of hope has been here, since we've been preaching the gospel, the 78207 has been shaken so much that it's no longer what people say it is. I cannot wait to see in the newspaper that the inner city, once known as one of the poorest, because of the people that live around here and because of their worship, because they kept on saying something about God is awesome, the west side is one of the most prosperous zip codes in the nation. Hallelujah. How many people believe that with me? If you don't believe it, it's not going to happen. But I need people to believe that this neighborhood, hallelujah, is being transformed one life at a time. One life at a time. Can you imagine all of you in the apartments and here? Can you imagine you saying, Pastor, man, I don't go to church, but I want to enroll into the military. I want to join God's armies. I don't know what it's going to take, but man, if it takes one person to make a difference, I want to be part of that army. We need that. I will pick up my weapon. Hallelujah. I will pick up my weapon. And I'm not talking about a gun. Listen, somebody pulls out a 9mm on you, take out the word of God. This one has 66 bullets, 66 scriptures, 66 bullets. You can't get better than that. This is an amazing weapon. You fight the devil with this hand, and you praise God with this hand. Let us give to the Lord and let us pray. The ushers are going to go past by the driver's side. You don't have to touch anything. Just do that. Those that are watching online, you can go to LCM. Even in your car, if you want to do it online, you can go to LCM.community. LCM.community/give. You can give there in your car as well. Like that. Don't forget, ministry goes on. The bills still got to get paid. And thank you for being obedient. The Bible says that you be faithful with the little, God will bless you with much more. We take care of God's house, He will take care of our house. Amen? So let us pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the word. We thank you for what you have done, Lord. I ask you that you bless this tithes and offering that are coming into the storehouse, Lord. That you bless their homes because they're trusting you, Father. They're releasing you, Lord. And Father, we believe that you are an awesome God, that you will provide. You will make a way if we only trust you. So, Father, bless the tithes and offering right now in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we all say, amen, amen. All right, guys, the ushers are going to go right through your cars and just be a blessing to the kingdom of God. Here we go. Hallelujah.
Lord, I find you in the seeking. Lord, I find you in doubt, and to know you is to love you, and to know so little else I need you. Oh, how I need you. The doubt, and to know you is to know
Letting the
light. Come on in. It's a new day today. And what a blessing for allowing us to be here as we gather. Bless your children from the crown of their heads to the bottom soles of their feet. Bless them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we all say, amen, amen. God bless you guys. We will see you on Wednesday. Que Dios me lo bendiga. Que tengan un buen día. God bless you. Hallelujah.